Okay, I could do that fight as I am right now, but I think I'm going to give it a little bit of time. Yes. Level up a little bit. So, let's head to the hollow area. I'll give it some time, and I'll come back to it at some point later. Or maybe I will do a jump cut later on. Because that's a hard fight. Not really hard, it's tedious. We could have pulled it off. Alright. Nothing here. Straight up. Come along. Yeah, let's team up. We haven't hung out with Philia in a while. What's my skills at? 118 points. Nothing to spend them on. Oh, right. We can use this. Implementable. So, how do I implement something? Unlocks next level hollow point reward. Implement? Okay. It implemented. Okay. Wait, I didn't read what it did. Crap. Can I go back up? Was it this? Crap. I wish they'd tell me what it did. Oh, hello. Added as a vendor. Shift several property. Double attack delay minus 50% accuracy plus. Ah, okay. Ah, hold on. Sword skill, disaster, hollow, slash attack, damage to HP, bleed to player. Ew, no, I don't want that. Why would I want that? From sword skill to sword skill. What's this? Test sword skills on level 100 to higher missionaries. Allows to chain up to 2 sword skills in sword skill chain recording mode. Ooh. I don't know what that is, but let's do it. So, test sword skills on level 100 or higher monsters. We're going to be running into a lot of those. Alright, teleport to another area. You want me over there, so that's where we'll go. We killed Zodias, so we move on to the next area. Which, how many areas are there are left? Zoom out. Okay, so this is going to lead us to this area, I'd assume? Maybe? This is the Guardian's Podium, and it could just lead to these areas, but I think it's going to lead to this chunk here, and this chunk here is going to be the final area. Alright, I need to go south, so to the Guardian's Podium. This way! Really wish the teleport brought us over here. Hello, well, you're 898. Damn. I was hoping they were 100, I'd get a head start on the, research. Oh well. What about you guys? 89. Even worse. I'm not fighting you guys right now, there's no point. There's a lot of chests over there that I haven't gotten yet. Never found out how to get them. I thought I'd get them when I was going through the dungeon, but the entirety of the dungeon was inside. So that plan didn't work. You can follow me, but I'm not fighting. 94. Damn. If you're level 100 or plus, I will fight you. Until then, get lost, noob. I love the soundtrack. I just noticed the music here. Dun, dun, dun. Dun, dun, dun. Yeah, I can't do music well. But it still sounds cool. You guys know what it sounds like. You're listening to it. Hey, where do I go? No idea, but there's a hollow mission over there. I think I know the one it is, too. Pretty sure that's the one with the three bulls or whatever. It's, I'll do it. It's a good... I get some good points and some good loot out of it. I remember there being like a hammer there or something. Oh, wait, you guys are the ones blocking it. Right. Okay, here we go. Come on, pull it off, pull it off, pull it off! Damn it! Every fucking time! Son of a bitch, every time. I hate this guy so much. Every time I try to use that skill, it gets canceled. That charge up is such bull. Oh, Iris! Aren't I supposed to be helping you on, like, 470-something? What the hell are you doing here? I'm pretty sure normal players can't leave the hollow area. I think Kirito's the only one, right? Or no, Philia's the only one who's restricted to the hollow area. That's right, that's right. Radio Shine! To finish him off. Boom! Good job. And this one's next. Before I do that, though, since these things are such high level, let's do this, this, Let's give her some extra experience. What do you say? She's 108. This will boost her up real quick. Am I even hitting him? Yeah, I am. Okay. Starburst stream. Let's knock him dead. His defense is down, so this should... Yeah, look at that.
It feels good to do damage.
Alright, you're the same level, right? Drops two-handed sword, Blazing Soul. Interesting. Infernal Rage! You're gonna die, fool. I wish it would tell me how much experience she got from each kill. Because I don't know how much that boosts by if it doesn't tell me. Because whenever I give her all XP, it only tells me zero XP gained. But I'm pretty sure it gives her a lot more than that. Does it tell me up top? No, it doesn't tell me up top. Alright, we get Jakub Saul. Okay. You know what? While we're here, let's go ahead and remove that. We're gonna upgrade my one-handed sword skill. I'm gonna work on getting my way to the scimitars. So I need a minimum skill of 600 to unlock that. And then that'll unlock scimitar, which I can slowly get to survival skills. Let's do it. All of these weapons in the game are viable, so it's not like using this one's gonna restrict me or make me worse. Yeah, I'll do slightly less damage, but like I said, all skills in the game are supposed to be viable. They wouldn't punish you for using them. What's this? I figured quest is this. Hold on, there's a couple of beetles shoving their butts in my face. I need to get rid of these. Could horizontal strike please charge up faster? Come on. Yep. Come on, horizontal strike. There we go. Did not get all of them. Come on, die. Oh, she's attacking. That's why he's having issues. Bam. What skill's my at? I'm at 560 and I need 600. Okay. Kill 10 song harpies. Yeah, all right, let's get started with the slaughter. Are any of my other attacks AoEs, or is it just horizontal AoE skill? Double auto attack. None of these are AoE skills. Oh wow, that one takes a lot out of my two highest stats. Wow. Oh right, I should be paying attention. Yep. Aw, they didn't do nearly as much as I thought it would. Adamantine Ore was in storage. She leveled up! Yay! Me giving her all my bonus, my experience is working! Okay, this kind of sucks. So that means I need to wait for them to spawn. 564. Well, I'm waiting. Are any of the skills I can learn AoE attacks? No, but let's go ahead and grab them. You know what? I have got so many extra points right now. I can afford to. And then... Look at what's here. Horizontal square. No. Ah, well. Oh, hello. You want to fight me? Get wrecked, son! And it's always disappointing when attacks don't do as much as you think they do. Although, I just realized I'm getting AoE auto attacks. I didn't know I could do that. Ooh, level 101. I didn't know you guys were high level. That's why horizontal's not killing you. You're too high level for that crap. That was 568. Ah, yeah. This is gonna level up so there is no edge there. Oh, you teleported. Why? Why did you teleport? Wait. Hold on. Don't have any particular tactics in mind. Focus on offense. You're a damage dealer. Well, let's take him out. Ah, just barely missed it. It's okay. I'll get that one, of course, Huntle. And then I can move on to this other one. And it's already dead. And I'll kill it with Sonic Weep. And that's all of them. You know, sword looks so badass when used as a one-hander. Booyah. Character info. You are a offensive support character. You're a damage dealer. Okay. Looks like all of my party members that I can get in this game are freaking damage dealers. Kind of be nice to have a support character. Although, I don't really know what a support character would do in this kind of game. Because there's really only combat roles. Oh, hello. Yeah, why not? I'll take you on. I don't know if taking on bigger monsters will give me more experience, more skill points, but I'll try it. You never know, right? Slant. What's that do? Diagonal attack. Vertical. It's a downward slash. Vorpal strike. You already know what Vorpal strike is. Used it a dozen times. Sonic leap. I'm just using all my skills now because I'm trying to figure out what I'll do. Class 78. Oh yeah, we are so close. Yep. Anything up yet? Star Q Prominence is almost up. Yay, we comboed! Boom, baby, boom! Parameters reduced. He lost some strength and he lost some movement speed. Lightning attack, what's this do? I don't know. But, oh, I think it upped my crit? No. Attack up, maybe? Defense up? No, that's defense down. I don't know. Alright, well, let's take this down. Oh, you want to switch? Okay, fine. Good job! 585. We are almost so close there. And then I can switch to a scimitar for a little bit, and I can... It won't take too long to get high enough level, or skill level, to unlock the awesomeness that will be the battle healing skill. Light from the fiery necklace went out. But it broke the barrier. Alright, that takes care of that seal. I also defeated the area boss, so that might mean... Next up is a new area. Yep, let's head out. Come on, Philia. To adventure! What new glorious world shall we see? We killed a mother effing dragon. What more can you throw at me, game? And don't reuse a regular mob skin, please. New message from... Silica. I was thinking, would you mind taking me with you the next time you're off adventuring? I promise I won't get in your way out in the field. Seems like every time I go to the hollow area, I get a lot more messages. Either panicking people, like, oh my god, what are you doing all the way out there? Or, there you go, because I can't find, what is this? Current location not connected to any other teleport crystal. It's not working. You need the other one up and running, okay. Ooh, big map. I like it when the map's big. Ha! Hello. Level 102? Nice! Hey, it's always nice fighting a monster high level. Well, high-ish. Still not getting any XP, so I'll go into her. But, I will. XP is XP, no matter who goes to. Hep! Remember the day where I flew across the map like a butterfly? I miss those days. Ooh, a griffin! We're getting to the point of the hollow area where things are starting to catch up. Level 100 is no longer a unique thing, it's a common thing, and I like that a lot. Stun the enemy? Well, that's a little late for that. I was gonna... Oh, you still want me to stun it? Okay. There you go. And I'll hit it with a four-pole strike. And it's gone. Poor thing never stood a chance. Windflower stone. Ooh, a black griffin. Or a chaos griffin. These things look so freaking badass. Gotcha! I don't know how I parried a freaking nosedive, but I did it! That's how awesome I am. These griffins look so badass. I know back in World of Warcraft when I was playing Alliance, this is a long time ago, I haven't played Alliance in ages. They had the ebony griffin, which was a, well, obviously it was a black feathered griffin with, what else was it? It was like a, I think it was a brown highlights or something like that. It was amazing looking, and it was a flying mount, so I used that thing everywhere. That was like my, if you saw the black griffin, guaranteed it was me, because it looked so badass. Especially since I was a death knight, and, you know, you've got this griffin that looks like, it's like straight out of hell or something. It's had like the black skin, or the black feathers, and the slightly reddish eyes. It was, oh, it looked so badass. And then I switched over to Alliance, and I lost it, and had to start riding the crappy wyvern around. That's one thing I hate, is that people always talk about a Horde getting the best stuff, which I will admit, the Horde tends to win out when it comes to Blizzard creating content. We get a lot of stuff and Alliance gets screwed. But I think this is an instance where Alliance won out. Because the Wyverns look so freaking stupid in comparison to the freaking Griffins. The Griffins are amazing, whereas the Wyverns are just like, hi, I'm a lion, and I've got some bat wings on me. Fear me! And that's it. Whereas the Griffins, you got lion, you got eagle. It's two classic things that are built together that turn into something amazing. And again, we just get a lion with bat wings on it. It's like, ugh. We drew the short end of the stick on that one. But enough complaining about WoW. We are playing Sword Art Online, which is like a super hyped up version of WoW. Can you imagine being able to play a game like World of Warcraft, like an actual MMO, but have it like Sword Art Online, where it's like the VR experience and you're actually in the game, not the death game. Let's leave that out, please. I don't want to be in a death game. I die too often in video games for me to want that to happen. I don't know if you noticed this in my other Let's Plays, but I tend to be along the line of, I wonder if this would work. Jump off cliff. Or every gamer out there is guilty of this. I don't care who you are, you've done it. When you first play a new game, one of the first things you do is you go over and you walk into the fire to see if it'll actually hurt you or not. The very first time you see a fire on the ground, you walk into it to see if it hurts you. Guaranteed. If you say you haven't done it, you're lying. Because every gamer's done it. It's like, I need to test the realism of this game. It's got amazing graphics. It's got the, there's this limb-severing system where you can sever specific limbs. It looks really cool. You know, they even got the anatomies right. They got the face structures right. Their voices are awesome. But there's one true test to see how real this game is. Do I get lit on fire? Or do I get lit on fire if I stand in the fire? That is how we judge if a game's realistic or not, if the fire hurts. And you always have that moment right after you step in the fire and you get lit on fire, obviously, where you're like, oh shit, why did I do that? That was stupid. And then right after that, followed by that moment, is the moment of, this game's pretty good. Like, we're basing our entire judgment of the game on whether or not that fire hurt. Where the hell am I going? I just realized that. Where the hell am I going? Did I go down there? Because I can fly down there. I think I gotta fly. I can fly! Hey. Oh, a little more. Oh, almost did not make that. Hello, Griffin. Use a sword skill? Okay, Vorpal Strike. Ooh, he tried to dodge me, but he didn't make it. Bye-bye, buddy. 605. Okay. Skills. Learn that. I don't actually need either of that, so we're going to learn that. And we're going to learn all the scimitar skills that we can. Okay, which is apparently just that. So equipment. And we're going to equip the scimitar. Oh, wow, that looks really cool. That looks really, really awesome. Oh, I wish you could dual wield these things. Hit. Oh god, we're doing like no damage to this guy. Okay, the scimitar class is apparently very skill based. Cause that was a lot right there. Our regular attacks weren't doing jack diddly. But oh boy, when the skill attack set in, he got wrecked. Reaver! Ooh, bleeding. It's not fantastic, but it's something. Thank you. Looks like we're going down. Charge in! Fellow Crescent! See how much damage this does. Ooh, when it hits, it does a lot. Use a sword skill? I can't. I don't have a lot of sword skills right now, so kind of on the low end of abilities. Reaver! There we go. I can combo with that. I think Scimitar is like a class that does a lot of debilitating effects. Because every time I attack, I'm adding something. I think a while ago it was bleeding. I think I got somebody with stun a while ago. Woohoo! Gotta be careful. Where to now? Ah, I think I see. We're gonna hop on this bridge. Woohoo! Not from there. We're gonna hop on it from here. Hit! I love how they have the dash mechanic actually useful. Like, yeah, it's for dodging attacks and everything, but then they have this, where you actually use it outside of combat. I love games that use that. If you can use a battle skill outside of battle, I love it. Because, you know, a lot of times, when you're in a fight, you don't think to use a lot of that stuff. Like, I don't use half of these skills all the time. Why? Because I just don't think about it. I kind of ignore them. But then, when you're out of combat, and you're not having to focus on these, establish now possible teleport between these locations. No, don't teleport. I don't want to do that. We're so close to the exit, I can taste it. But a lot of times in combat, you're not thinking, oh, I should use these buffs. Or use this skill. Whatever. I'll check what I was saying. I'm sorry. The next area is up ahead.